Information shared on the following program is for general information purposes only. It does not constitute legal, tax, investment, or other advice, nor is it intended to recommend any particular investments, products, or financial instruments. Always seek advice from your financial advisor, attorney, or accountant with regard to investment, legal, or tax questions.
If it ain't broke, don't fix it. If it's mixed, don't try to mix it. Think before you speak, and look before you leap. And if it's wound up, don't try to wind it. If it's not lost, don't try to find it. It always helps to make it easy on yourself.
I couldn't agree more. So why in the world does the government keep trying to fix what ain't broken?
Welcome to the only show in the country dedicated to helping savers worry less about money, The Worry-Free Retirement. Your host, nationally recognized retirement specialist, five-time author, and fiduciary, Tony Walker.
In his catchy little song, If It Ain't Broke, Don't Fix It, recording artist John Anderson reminds us how often we humans try to change things that in many cases are better off left alone. If you've been keeping an eye on our friends in Washington, you'll notice they seem to have their fair share of the ain't broke, don't fix it moments as well, and they seem to be occurring more frequently. Problem is, when they decide to change up things, it doesn't affect them, it affects us. Now, recently, while we were out working hard and saving hard, they were meeting in the halls of Congress, pulling off another if it ain't broke, don't fix it moment as they passed into law something they refer to as the Secure Act, a potentially devastating law that can cost us dramatically in the future, consequences to our retirement accounts, particularly your 401k plan. Well, welcome, folks, to the Worry-Free Retirement. I am that little man in the sweater vest, 401k rollover specialist and fiduciary, Tony Walker. And today, we conclude our series on your required minimum distribution, or RMD, and the effects that this new law recently passed called the Secure Act, and how it will affect your retirement both today and after you're dead and gone. Now, before we get started, though, I've got to introduce to you the producer of the Worry-Free Retirement, America's favorite financial sidekick, Mr. Aaron Orander, along with his favorite sidekick, our technical director, Miss Megan Murphy. Okay, let's back up a minute and see where we are with this if it ain't broke, don't fix it law that was just passed called the Secure Act. The resulting changes to this law and your 401k distributions reminds me of something I've been saying for years, and here goes. While the 401k is a great way to save for retirement, turns out it's a lousy way to plan for it. The two major changes that I see that were enacted into this law, the extension of the RMD age while you're alive, and the reduction of time allowed for your children to withdraw that money when they inherit it from you when you die. Now, before I explain the what, let me take a stab at the why. Why did Congress go and try to fix something, the RMD rules as they previously stood, with something that may break your bank even more? In other words, they tried to fix something that ain't broken. I'm going to take a stab at the why by comparing the government's household to your household. The amount of money coming into the household, I'm going to call that the ingo. And the amount of money that goes out is called the outgo. So let's say you are still working at a job that pays you $5,000 a month, all right? That's your gross salary. Now, by the time they withhold taxes from your pay, that becomes your net pay. The net pay is the amount that is deposited each month. That's your ingo. And in this case, it's $3,000. But your expenses, the outgo, let's say, to run your household, is $4,000 a month. So when the outgo exceeds the ingo, that's a no-go, or something the economists refer to as a deficit or deficit spending. But since you have an unlimited amount of money you can borrow on a credit card, let's say, you cover this deficit of $1,000 each month by simply borrowing it on your credit card. Now, this method you're using of covering the growing deficit works great Until one day, out of the blue, the credit card company calls wanting all of their money plus the interest you owe them for it. So, where's the money going to come from to pay them back? You might say, well, I guess I could take it out of my 401k, couldn't I? But how much of that money is really yours? You see, buried inside that 401k is what I call that infamous tax tumor. And the problem is, we don't know at what rate in the future Uncle Sam is going to tax your 401k. Well, guess what? The government is running their house much the same way. Their outgo is much higher than their ingo. In fact, in 2019, the U.S. deficit was $1 trillion. That's money that has been created out of thin air, borrowed, if you will, and one day somebody's got to pay that back. But from where? Where might the government go to get additional ingo needed to cover this debt, this much outgo? What's the solution, Tony? How can I use and enjoy more of my money now rather than later? How can I assure that as much as possible, this money will go tax-free to the kids as opposed to maybe the government coming back and wanting to tax it to make up these deficits? Well, when I return, I'm going to show you just how you're going to do that. You stay tuned. We're going to dive into this RMD and how you can arm yourself with proactive information that can help you keep more of your money in your pocket. You're watching The Worry-Free Retirement. I'll be right back. Who can you trust? It's one of the most important decisions you'll have to make. Question is, are you ready? Well, we're here to help at Tony Walker Financial. You know, we care more about you than we do your money, and we have over 2,000 happy clients and an A-plus rating with the Better Business Bureau to prove it. Rolling over a 401k, confused about Social Security, maybe you're afraid of running out of money. Learn how to use and enjoy and protect your hard-earned money. Log on now to TonyWalkerFinancial.com and let's get started.
I'm teaching you bad grammar today, but this is what we say. If it ain't broke, don't fix it.
I don't know about you, but I've had a bunch of it ain't broke, don't fix it moments. My most recent involved the replacement of our home's perfectly good 70-gallon water heater with a new tankless water heating system. Now, there's a good reason for this, and her name is Stella. You see, Stella is an 85-pound long-haired black Russian terrier who needs to be professionally groomed. Problem is, Stella gets sicker than a dog, no pun intended, anytime we try to take her in the car. So, to avoid having to drive her to a groomer only to see her slobber all the way home, we decided to build a small room in our new home for the dog groomer to come to us. Problem is, located in that dog room, we kind of forgot, was this huge water heater that was right in the middle of the area trying to groom Stella. And seeing as though I always wanted a tankless water system anyway, I justified my decision to remove this perfectly good, bulky hot water heater and replace it with this wall-mounted tankless system. Now, it all worked great until the other day when the hot water quit running. Turns out, if it ain't broke, don't fix it, cost me a bunch of time, heartache, and money. Speaking of needlessly spending money on something we don't need, let's get back to the new law passed in the halls of Congress, the Secure Act, and whether this newfangled law is really of any benefit over the old law. Now, I have numerous concerns with the Secure Act, but the primary assumes that, like most Americans, you have a good deal of your money in the stock market, which, as of the date of this recording, January 7th, 2020, it's at an all-time high. But given the history of the stock market, we know at some point it will go down. It always does. So what's the big deal? Well, it's not unless you are required to take money out of your account when it goes down. It's not a big deal. But with an RMD, it's going to be required to be taken out. Let's take a look at this graphic now. So we're assuming we're going to go back into 2005, and we imagine you have $300,000, and under these new rules, you're 72. We've calculated your RMD, which is about $11,000. Now, keep in mind, the whole purpose of the required minimum distribution is for the government to force you to take out more and more money until you die so they can get their taxes buried within that thing. So after the first distribution, you still have money because the market went up back then. The next year, the market goes up again. You take out your minimum distribution. Notice it's a little more, but it keeps going up and you're like, what the heck? We keep fast forwarding And if we have another 08, when the market, the S&P dropped 37%, okay, notice you still got to take out more money. And look at this, all of a sudden your $300,000 dives down to $205,000. You see, folks, the stock market's fine, but if you don't have a diversified way of dealing with RMDs, which at Tony Walker Financial we do, we call this the split IRA concept. If you don't have something like that, you're going to get caught in a situation where you're going to have to take money out of an account when it's going down. Not a good idea. So what we do with the split IRA, we have one or more buckets. The first bucket is our Charles Schwab bucket, and of course, if you want to make that risky, we can. The other bucket or buckets are fixed annuities. These are guaranteed not to lose any principal. So let's just say we have a down market and we decide not to take it out of Schwab, but rather take it out of here. We can do that. The RMD law says that you only have to send the government their fair share. They don't tell you which bucket you have to take it out of. And we have a full-time staff that we charge no additional fee for these services. Again, folks, we're not money managers. We're not just shuffling around your money like a deck of cards. We are retirement planning specialists, and this is the real value we bring to the table. We're trying to make sure we get you as much money as you can back to you at the least amount of cost. All right, so that's one issue. What's the second major issue? Well, this involves your kids. And what that means is this new law has to do with the RMD after you die and what's going to happen to this tax-infested 401k when your kids inherit it. Now, what I decided to do here, let's walk over to the whiteboard, and I'm going to share with you this 10-year rule. Let's get that whiteboard out right now. Okay, the first thing we need to do is remember the first major change. This is where it gets kind of weird. Again, the RMD of old was 70 and a half, but now the government's letting you push that date off. Why would they do that? Why wouldn't they want their tax revenue now? Why are they putting that off another year and a half before you have to take it? It really doesn't make any sense when now you look at the kids. See, the former RMD, or the required minimum distribution for the kids, when they inherit your money, let's say it's the $300,000, okay, in our previous example, you had $300,000 in your IRA or 401k, you die and leave it to a child. And let's say that child happens to be a high-paid executive or maybe a surgeon, and that child makes, you know, $500,000 a year in income, and they're in a 40% tax bracket. Now, under the old law, they could do something called a stretch. What that meant was, over their lifetime, over a long period of time, they could stretch out their required minimum distribution, meaning they didn't have to take as much money. So think about this. The new rule is they have to take it out in 10 years. Now, why is that very significant? Because now, let's take this example of somebody that's in a very high tax bracket. This $300,000 is going to have to be paid out over this 10-year window. And again, if we're assuming this person's in a 40% bracket, that means over $120,000 is going to be eaten up in taxes. Here is the other concern. Here's the other reason I think they're pushing off this area, and they're going to pull back in or rein back in how long your kids can defer it. And this is the magic date of 2026. Now, what happens in 2026? In 2026, the current tax laws, listen very carefully, this is so important, especially when we get into the next segment. The current tax laws will expire. We are at some of the lowest tax rates I've ever seen in my 35 years in this business. They are so, so low. This is why you need to start doing planning now. The government knows if you put this off, if you put off the pain, if you don't want to deal with the tax tumor, after 2026, we don't know what will happen, but remember, they got to pay for these deficits. The debt's spiraling out of control. There's over close to $30 trillion locked up in all kinds of qualified plans that hasn't been taxed. Where do you think they might go get the money? From your 401k plan. And at what tax rate? Remember, folks, we have no clue what that 401k is worth until you convert it to cash, pay the tax, and spend it. Right now, it's just on paper. Right now, it's probably at risk in the stock market. Secondly, you don't even know the taxes due, and this is your life savings. Well, here's my suggestion. Get a game plan. Let us take a look at this. And as you're going to see in the next segment, you do have options. Regardless of whether you're 72, older, or even just planning for retirement, we can show you how to maximize your RMD. Oh, by the way, I want to tell you about something. My newest book coming out, let's go over back to the monitor here, Aaron. In late February, I'm excited to announce the upcoming launch of my newest book, Live Well, Die Broke. Now, don't judge this book by its cover, because in it, I'll share with you my life story and insights I have gained from meeting with over 15,000 savers. The book is expected to be launched in late February. Now, why are we talking about it now? We want to offer you an early bird seat to get in on a huge discount. The discount is only going to be for 24 hours when we release it. So what you need to do is go to livewelldiebroke.com. Livewelldiebroke.com. Enter your name, email, and mobile phone number for VIP access to our digital book launch later in February. This will give you an inside update and VIP pricing for the launch of the book again in February. So log on, live well, die broke. I think this book is going to really help you gain a perspective on how to better use and enjoy your money without the fear of running out of it. All right, when we come back, let's take a look at the age 72 issues. I'm going to give you five options available to you if you're 72 or older. Now, if you're not 72 or older, stay tuned, because one day you're probably going to be, Lord willing. And then secondly, there's things you can do now to avoid where we're going to be at 72. Also, you may have a parent or parents that are at this age, and this will extremely be beneficial to you to understand what their options are, seeing as though one day you're probably going to inherit some of this money. So stay tuned. You're watching the Worry-Free Retirement. I'll be right back. Have you recently retired, been laid off, or offered a pension buyout? Has the company you work for moved, been acquired, or closed its doors forever? And finally, do you have a 401k with a previous employer you'd like to move to safer territory? Then take advantage of this opportunity to move your 401k or lump sum pension to Tony Walker Financial. Let's meet in person to discuss your retirement options. Log on now to TonyWalkerFinancial.com to schedule your free, no obligation appointment. Let us help you today. Welcome back to the Worry-Free Retirement, and we're getting ready to talk about what you can do if you are at or near this new RMD age of 72. Now, again, if you're not 72, don't turn the channel, because one day, again, you will be probably 72, Lord willing, or you may have parents in this age range, and again, this is going to affect you, and you might even want to share this information with them in case they're missing the show. Remember, assuming you have parents this age, at their death, you're going to have to deal with the dreaded tax tumor sooner rather than later under these new rules. So let's first look at the inherent risk inside the 401k, the IRA, and then take a look at this particular options that we're going to look at. We talked about the stock market risk, but what can we do in addition to that to be proactive? Well, the first thing you can do of these five options is basically spend it. You know, think about this, folks. Let's look at these tables. This is called the mortality tables. And this tells you how many people are expected to die this year at different ages. Hundreds of thousands of people will be dead. And we don't know if you're going to be one of them or I'm going to be one of them. So we have to strike a balance between using our money now and deferring it. And I would say there is nothing wrong if you're getting up close to 72 to go on and look forward to getting this money and spending it. The second thing you can do is gift it. Now, there's two parties you can gift this to, and it's tax-free either way. You can gift it to family members. We can show you how to do that. In other words, you take the RMD, pay taxes at these low rates that we're in right now, and then give it tax-free away to family, or you can give it directly to charities. Now, this is called a qualified charitable distribution, and there are certain rules that govern this, but the advantage of this is the money goes directly to charity, not you. Yeah, you might say, well, I still get a deduction, don't I? Yeah, but there's some reasons that you don't want that hitting your tax return. And we have someone in our office who specializes in the tax planning for this. So this might be something you want to take advantage of and can save you a lot of taxes on other things like Social Security. So keep that in mind. All right, the third thing that we can do with this is diversify it. That's right, we can diversify that. Now, what's so cool about this strategy is you take the RMD out, and we can show you how to set up a plan of tax-advantaged mailbox money. That's right. I can show you how to take that after-tax money, grow it for the future, and set up what we call mailbox money. So that is something we can certainly help you do. The fourth item is convert it. Now, let me be real clear on this. If you had $300,000 in your 401k, back to that one example, The RMD is not convertible. So let's say it was $11,000. You're going to have to take that distribution out and pay taxes on it. But there's nothing that says, again, depending on your tax bracket, that you can't take out additional money above the RMD and convert it into what we call a Roth IRA. Again, we'll be happy to run the tax numbers on this. Now, why would you want to do that? Well, think about this. Let's say you got a bunch of money languishing in the bank, and that money is going to be taxed in the future at rates we don't know, right? This 401k. If you take out more money now, pay the tax now, number one, in the future, it's not subject to the RMD calculation. And number two, and best of all, when you die, not if you die, when you die, that money goes tax-free to your children. Let me repeat that. Tax-free to your children. So this is something to really think about. All right, the fifth one and my favorite is actually insure it. This is why having adequate permanent, I didn't say term insurance, why you need permanent life insurance so in the future you can deal with this tax tumor. You know, life insurance, if owned properly, and again, we're not talking about term life, that provides no permanent benefits whatsoever. A permanent policy, if owned properly, will provide tax-free, cold hard cash to your kids, bar none. It is still one of the greatest investments ever created. Why? Because of all the insurance coverage you're gonna buy, it's the only one guaranteed to pay. It's called permanent life insurance. And yes, at Tony Walker Financial, we can show you various options where you can buy life insurance either on yourself, children, or even in some cases, kids with that minimum distribution. And again, what we're trying to do is get out of this tax-infested situation that you're in and try to create more tax-free money for you and your family. Well, I hope you've enjoyed these five tips and what to do with your RMD. Don't forget, we can help you with this at Tony Walker Financial. All you got to do is log on to TonyWalkerFinancial.com and let's get started. Well, in the meantime, does the Bible have anything to say about this phenomenon of us humans trying to constantly fix things that ain't broken? It sure does, but first, I got to get me a cup of coffee. I'll be right back. You're watching The Worry-Free Retirement. Who can you trust? It's one of the most important decisions you'll have to make. Question is, are you ready? Well, we're here to help at Tony Walker Financial. You know, we care more about you than we do your money, and we have over 2,000 happy clients and an A-plus rating with the Better Business Bureau to prove it. Rolling over a 401k, confused about Social Security, maybe you're afraid of running out of money. Learn how to use and enjoy and protect your hard-earned money. Log on now to TonyWalkerFinancial.com and let's get started. Years ago, while I was still in college, I was visiting with my father, who quite frankly was terrible at fixing stuff around the house. Now, on this particular day, I walked in to see him kneeling over the downstairs commode trying to fix the commode seat. I asked him what he was doing, and it's a kind of a smart aleck voice. He said, "What does it look like I'm doing? I'm changing out this old commode seat for one of these new cushiony ones." Now, while I watched him try to get the old commode seat off the toilet, I noticed that he had a long screwdriver and a hammer and started to bang on the long bolt connecting the seat to the toilet. Didn't look like a good idea to me, but after about three quick licks of that hammer, nothing really happened. And I said, "Hey, Dad, what are you doing there now?" And he said, "Well, I think if I just hit it one more time." And I said, "Yeah, why don't you go ahead and hit it one more time?" Which he did, popping off the commode seat. And then, what seemed like minutes later, Dad's excitement of getting the commode seat off quickly turned to dismay as he watched the commode start cracking and spilling water all over the floor. About this time, my dad's wife walks in hearing all this racket and says, "What happened?" To which Dad looks up in a scowling face and says, "Tony told me to hit it one more time." Another, if it ain't broke, don't fix it moment for sure. Well, what does God have to say about us humans always trying to fix what ain't broken? Plenty. And just one example of this is found in the book of Galatians, where we see the Apostle Paul lamenting over the fact that after all God did for mankind in sending His Son to die for our liberty, the freedom of enjoying life in a way that only God and Christ can provide, in walks man to try to fix what ain't broken. We see this in Galatians 3:1, where Paul asks a question of these religious ain't broke, don't fix it folks, and says, "You foolish Galatians, who has bewitched you? Before whose eyes Jesus Christ was publicly portrayed as crucified. He goes on down to verse 2. This is the only thing I want to find out from you. Did you receive the Spirit by the works of the law or by hearing through faith? Are you so foolish, having begun by the Spirit, are you now being perfected by the flesh? Now, what Paul is saying is this: no matter your station in life, no matter whether you have a gajillion dollars in your 401k or only a few dollars in your pocket, God sent His Son to die for us to give us the freedom to enjoy all that His Spirit can provide. But man in his flesh, he's going to monkey with things and these rules and constantly try to change the gig on us, like they recently did with our 401k plans. So what's the solution, you say? Well, when it comes to the truth of God, don't try to change what He has so graciously already provided. Accept this grace, this mercy for what it is, and I assure you, you'll quit worrying so much about money, and this, my friend, is something you can take to the bank. Well, how about you? You may be sitting there and you got money stockpiled in your 401k. You're hoping you'll have all this money one day. Did you realize that all that money you see on those IRA and 401k statements isn't really yours? Do you have a plan to use and enjoy the protect that money now rather than later? Or are you just going to sit there and hope for the best? Well, here's my advice. Let's meet right now to set up a game plan so you can maximize what's rightfully yours. Not only for you and during your lifetime, but for your loved ones when you're dead and gone. Now, here's the best part. There is no cost or obligation to meet with me in person. To arrange a meeting, all you got to do is log on to TonyWalkerFinancial.com. Now, once there, you're going to click on that Let's Get Started button. That is confidentially sent to our offices in Bowling Green, Kentucky. They will follow up with you to set up a convenient time to talk with me in person by phone. Or if it warrants us meeting in person, of course we can meet at either our Bowling Green, Louisville, or Lexington, Kentucky offices. Again, so take action. Get control of this 401k. Let's get a game plan for your RMDs. And again, it doesn't matter whether you're 50 or 80, you're still going to have to deal with that tax tumor, and you're still going to need a game plan on how best to use and enjoy and protect your money. And oh, by the way, don't forget, for special VIP pricing on my next book coming out in late February, log on now to livewelldiebroke.com. That's livewelldiebroke.com. And what you're going to do there is put in your name, phone number, email address, and again, we will alert you to this 24-hour special pricing of the book when it's launched sometime in late February. So log on now, get your VIP pricing set up, and we'll let you know when the special launch of the new book comes out. Well, in the meantime, we've enjoyed this series on RMDs. You know what we're going to talk about next week? We're going to ask an interesting question, and I'm going to dive into that. And here it is. What is the stock market? It's a great question, and what we're finding out, most people really don't know how to define it. I'm going to take a stab at it next week, but you remember, between now and then, if all else fails, you be worry-free. Make it a good one.
If it ain't broke, don't fix it. If it's mixed, don't try to mix it. Think before you speak. And look before you leap. And if it's wound up, don't try to wind it. If it's not lost, don't try to find it. It always helps to make it easy.